Hi Aries, welcome to your daily reading. I hope you're well. So it's the 20th and we do have the full moon going on right now. You won't be able to see it in the daytime, but we have the full moon in Aries and we have Mercury aligned with Venus up to a yawn energy at Uranus and Taurus, being free, liberated, doing something innovative, new, something different, Uranus energy here. So we have the grand trine at two T-squares, rectangle, a yod. So the double T-square has to do with Moon and Aries connecting over to rising Scorpio, Saturn in Aquarius, and the Sun in Libra. Pluto in Capricorn, Mars in Libra. So to me, there's something about possibly communicating about your truth to a person, understanding, seeking an understanding where there could be, you know, people who are unhappy and expressing how they feel in a relationship and doing more independent things instead, or there could be breakups because Mercury direct, speaking your truth about a partnership in Libra, Mars, very serious, very passionate and energized. Venus and Sagittarius, a love of adventure. And then Uranus and Taurus, breaking free. So you could also do something that would be, you know, different. Travel. Sagittarius is about travel, long distance travel. So you could do something like that. But also, so for Aries, we have the moon, emotions are strong, intuition, squared off to Pluto, so there's a resistance to change. But there is a connection between Chiron and Jupiter retrograde, I'm sorry, Jupiter direct in Aquarius. So Jupiter direct at 22 degrees connected to Chiron at 9 degrees of Aries. Basically, if you can be very confident, this will look good and be very beneficial for you in society. So other people will see this and possibly you could get recognized, or you could have land a job interview by being very confident, overcoming any wounds of the past. It could also be overcoming a fear of failure. You could be very rewarded by people seeing you as a strong leader. So paying attention to how you feel is important with the full moon in opposition to the sun. The sun wants partnership, but Aries wants to be an independent person. So I feel like you just have to have a good balance between, you have to speak your truth, but you have to have a good balance between doing things on your own and also as a couple or with others. So if you're not in a relationship, this could just be about overcoming a fear of failure and then being brave and getting rewarded for that. Rising Scorpio is very deep. It can also be dark. There's something dark always about Scorpio. It's sort of a life cycle, a beginning and an end. So let's see what we're getting here for you, Aries. Okay, so let's see what we get for Aries for the tarot for you today. I hope you're doing well. This full moon, I think you might feel energized to exercise or do something for your physical self, health, fitness, because the moon rules over Cancer. Cancer is about the home, safety, security, and your roots. And it's very nurturing. So you could do something for your health and your fitness today, your physical self. Okay. Jupiter in Aquarius is about good luck and good fortune for everyone in the collective, connected to Chiron in the Aries. overcoming fear or overcoming failure, fear of failure or past hurts. All right, let's see, spirit and angel guides, what are we getting here for Aries for today? What do they need to see? Ten of Wands. Okay, I see here. Six of Cups. So we have the Six of Cups energy coming in. Friendship, harmony, good feelings between you and another person. Actually, the crossing energy is that there's a victory, a reward, recognition, somebody sees you. This could be that Chiron healing where you're doing really well, you're feeling confident, you're overcoming any fear coming from low self-esteem or anything. You're doing really well, feeling good. But there's something here about Ten of Wands. Lots of responsibility on your shoulders. What's coming in for Aries, please? Oh, wow. Past energy. Okay, so we have a past energy of the Five of Pentacles, feeling left out in the cold or feeling abandoned. The feelings could be lingering. Oh, wow. Four of Cups, dissatisfaction. Not excited about something. Four of Swords, not wanting to communicate, just sort of shutting yourself off from people. That could be the full moon energy where you are needing to align. What's coming in is it Aries energy right now? What's coming in as Aries energy for the day? The Lovers. So there's a choice. For some of you here, there's like a choice. If you're not satisfied in your love life, you're unhappy, your circumstances here are changing. You may decide to be single, Nine of Coins. Wow, it could also be about a job, like maybe you're unhappy at your job, it doesn't pay enough. You have a choice, because we have Ten of Pentacles right here, money, wealth, and abundance. So we have financial security, money, wealth, abundance. So these energies are about finding what you want. What is it that you want? Because you're getting something really good in here. You have a choice. The Death card on the bottom, there's something here about change. There's something that transforms or changes from this unsatisfied state of being. Now, these two cards, the way they flipped, it could have been interchanged. You're getting attention from someone new, or you're getting some kind of attention. And you're not satisfied, so you have a choice to make. It could be a job, anything. Oh, wow, Nine of Swords. Very concerned about possibly some kind of conflict or dissatisfaction that there might be that could be causing you mental stress. Two of Pentacles, weighing your options. Page of Coin, could be somebody coming towards you. Three of Coin. Some of you, it could be a coworker. Two of Cups and the Knight of Water. Yeah, so there could be a new love option for many of you. This is really interesting. The outcome is a Ten of Pentacles, money in abundance, financial security, wealth, commitments. The energy that comes in is peace. Like, you just don't want to. There could be someone here who is not paying attention to you as well. Four of Cups, Four of Swords. The environment has changed with the Wheel of Good Luck and Good Fortune, Jupiter direct. The environment. So Wheel of Fortune would be Jupiter direct and Aquarius. The environment is changing. Your energy is the lovers, which means you have knowledge of a choice. You know you can make a choice. So, outcome is Ten of Pentacles. Oh, the Wheel of Fortune turning in your favor. Good luck, good fortune. Things are changing, Jupiter direct. So, what is the lovers here for Aries? What is the lovers? My goodness. So some of you are unsatisfied, possibly walking away. What is Four of Swords? It's Minor Arcana. Oh, wow. Something here is going to be rectified. Justice in the world. This is a completion. Two Major Arcanas symbolizing, you know, completions that is fair, just, balanced. It could be a divorce for some. It could be some kind of legal matter that's turning up in your favor. So what is the Wheel of Fortune? What is changing for Aries here in the environment? What is Wheel of Fortune? Okay, trapped, feeling isolated, trapped. What is the Six of Cups in the crossing? Or what is this Six of Wands, Six of Cups? Victories. Overcoming difficult situations. A friend coming in. Page of Cups. A person coming forward with a nice message. So why is there... Okay, we have a King of Water. Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpio energy. Somebody coming forward with showing you love or appreciation. What is the Ten of Pentacles here then? I got a Page of Wands, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Could be any kind of fire sign, messenger. What is the Four of Cups? The Hierophant. Some of you are unhappy either in your job or your marriage. What is the Hierophant? What is the Hierophant? Ordered an institution. Two of Cups. This is crazy. This is like, I'm not happy. I want something to change. I'm not going to invest my emotions into this. What is Eight of Cups? What is Eight of Cups here? Why is it coming through as leaving or making a choice to walk away? Oh, wow. Some of you are taking your power back, Emperor. You just want to be on your own, or maybe you want to leave a job here, Five of Pentacles, because you want more money, power, authority. You want to be in control. All right. What is this Ten of Pentacles and Page of Wands? Some of you want to run your own business. Okay. Four of Swords. There's heartbreak or pain, and then there's something about not speaking or not communicating. What is Ten of Wands? What is the Ten of Wands here? Wow, there's something sad or disappointing. So this is like stuck in negative feelings. Oh, wow. So the Fool comes up. You're breaking free. You are liberated from whatever it was that was getting you down. Knight of Coin is on the bottom. An offer. King of Coin. Chariot. Ace of Cups. Ten of Cups. My goodness. Look at this with the Tower. Underlying here is someone coming towards you, making an offer, a real offer, that is very unexpected. And I think what it does is it makes you start to question your circumstances, and your circumstances then change. So you're thinking, you know, if you get a promotion somewhere or another job that offers you something else, and you're liberated. You're out of a bad situation, or you're out of a situation that you were unhappy in. Five of coin, five of cups, ten of wands. Something much better with the world and the justice and the wheel of fortune. Okay, what have we got here for the fool? The fool means you're liberated. Ten of pentacles and strength. Some of you, it could be a long-term relationship, the judgment, making a big decision. Wow, if there's something here painful, there's a reckoning, justice being served. But this is like a spiritual reckoning, a judgment, a day of judgment. Three of cups. The death card was underlying the main tarot, so something's going to change about something that is worrying you, causing you worry and nightmares even. Okay, so let us see what other messages do we have here for Aries. Okay, the angel of balance is coming into a situation. Eight of cups, though, with your energy with the lovers, eight of cups is emotions. And sometimes your emotions can overpower you during a full moon. So you just want to make sure, like, you are in balance and making a right choice. Wow. Walking away. Rest and rejuvenation. Interesting. Ten of Wands is underlying everything, which can be you've been taking on too much. Oh, anxiety. And the cornucopia. Oh my goodness. How the heck? So somehow you go from... There's a better offer coming. I mean, I don't know what it is, but it's something better because Ten of Pentacles, many doors are opening here. Ten of Pentacles, the change, the Wheel of Fortune, the justice. Now, it could be many things. It could be a court decision in your favor where you get to walk away from some kind of, you know, situation in the legal system. You're getting some very good news, some kind of a victory. Underlying was, it's been weighing heavily upon your shoulders. So Aries, I'm gonna leave this here for you. Thank you for tuning in to your daily reading. If any of you are interested in any of my jewelry products, these are the bracelets. This one is selenite and clear quartz, which is good for clarification of your energy. But I will leave this here for you, Aries. Thank you and take care.